There is some kind of organization in my mess on this table. I swear to God. Oh.
Find some time to do something. Find some time to do something. Find some time to do something. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Yeah. Alright. How you guys doing? We're about to clock it in for the day. Pukeniken Podcast. Hopefully this is the actual official episode number one. I filmed and recorded yesterday, but unfortunately the camera only ran out of battery already. I mean, ran out of battery after 30 minutes, even though I recorded for almost an hour and 30 minutes. So that's what happened with me yesterday. So obviously I can't post that because it's just half an hour of video and then hour and a half of voice recording, so it just doesn't make sense to post. And you know, it was just a good little warm-up I could have just trying this thing out that I'm trying right now. So hopefully this is the first official episode. I got battery charged up to the full overnight, and then cleared out my SD card as well on my camera, so hopefully, please work for me. And the mic's been working pretty well the whole time, and worth it, man. I got the mic stand and the mic for only 35 euros. Pretty good. It was on sale. Bought it on the internet, dude. Yeah, so that's been really, really fun. But we're gonna get into it, man. We're gonna see what's been going on in the world. I'm gonna start off with a little bit of sports, if you guys don't mind. I love my sports, and one of the first things I always do in the morning, I check my sports, man. I check my scores because I love watching U.S. sports, but unfortunately, they're always late night, or they're in the, you know, early in the morning. Like, you know, they just basically start. What I'm basically trying to say is they just start when Finnish people are supposed to be going to sleep, or supposed to be sleeping. So it's kind of tragic. So, but at least it gives me a little fun thing, a little routine I can always do in the morning before I start getting into my work. I just scroll through my Instagram, and you know, it's nothing but just sports media, all kinds of sports, friggin' Instagrams, full of my feed. So, okay, so yesterday we had a little bit of NBA, of course. NBA pretty much is every night, but NBA is one of those sports where it's really, really tragic, the timeline wise, because at least the NFL, I can watch that on Sundays, obviously at 8. But Marona mia, NBA is always just in the most, like, some of the best games start usually like at 2 a.m. or 3 a.m. My God, I can't deal with that, man. Regular man needs some regular sleep, man. Lakers finally took a dub. Is that official? Westbrook actually proved his worth. Dude, sports media been going crazy over that motherfucker. Sports media have been going crazy over that motherfucker. He's always been like a star player, and then he's had a few quiet seasons. And what does he do with his career? He just goes head-to-head and joins the most popular team in basketball, pretty much, the Lakers. And LeBron James is there, and Lakers is just pretty much, if you're a Laker, you are getting coverage on sports media, dude. If you're like a bench player for the Detroit Pistons, nobody cares about you. Nobody knows your name. Post game, Nobody wants to interview you. All right. But if you're a Laker, even if you're a bench player, even if you're in the practice squad, they're going to want to interview you, dude. So obviously, given that situation, Russell Westbrook been under a lot of scrutiny. But then as soon as he does a little something or something, you know, sports media, oh my God, he's back. Carries the Lakers for the win. I'm like, all right. Okay, that's great. Kyle Kuzma absolutely dunks it on Embiid. Oh my goodness gracious. He does yam it on Embiid. He does yam freaking casserole it on fucking Embiid. You know what I'm saying? Scotty Barnes goes coast to coast and throws it down at full speed. I love those kind of plays. I see it. I'm watching it. Oh yeah. This one was the one where they absolutely smacked into a lady with her drinks and her phone out, and she was on the court side. This guy, Scotty Barnes, right? Yeah, Scotty Barnes, he gets the ball from one end, right? And then he runs it to his end, or like the end he's supposed to score. Full speed, right? Just bop, 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 dribbling. Jumps up, elevates, tries to go for the dunk. And then he dunks it, nasty, wow. And then he lands with so much momentum and forward momentum, right? And he pretty much lands like, I think maybe like a meter, like his feet land like a meter before the making contact with the lady in the court side. She had her phone out and fucking drink and maybe like a fucking nacho with some freaking nice and hot warm cheese dip, you know? And then she just bam gets smacked by a freaking 250-pound fucking NBA player, huh? Gotta love it. But that's the courtside experience. She's going to go home and she's going to fucking like maybe, you know, rub one out to that kind of experience in the shower. No, wait, what? That might be a little too much. Yes, sir. My boy, wet like Devin Booker, drops 48 points, 6 assists, 5 rebounds, and 3 steals in a win versus the Spurs. Nice. Impressive that Spurs kind of chowed them. Yeah. Spurs definitely, as Damon Hill says, I gave him a good run for his money. Yeah, maybe they didn't. No. Okay, maybe they didn't. Devin Booker just popped off. Phoenix Suns won by like over 20. Let's see some plays. Coach Spo shoves Harrow into position to set up the play. Harrow then finishes the play with the drive to the basket. I want to see this. I love Tyler Harrow. I think he's a... I don't know if you're supposed to fucking say Tyler Hero or Harrow. Dude, the commentators say Hero, bro. But it's H-E-R-R-O. So isn't that supposed to be Harrow? Like, am I tripping? Am I absolutely faded? I think it's Harrow, bro. Like, I ain't trying to diss, but I think it's Harrow, bro. It's a little too cheese. It's almost a little too cheese if you call that guy Hero. Tyler Hero for the 3, for the game winner. Hero scores. He's the hero of our own hometown. Dude, just get the fuck out of here. Get the fuck out. LeBron misses the LeBron stat line by 2 points in a Lakers win. 25 points, 7 rebounds, 7 assists. Dude, this guy ain't even good, bro. This guy ain't even good, bro. Yeah, bro. He's 9-20 FG, bro. That's like under half. FG, not even 3-point. Just FG, right? And this is a man who can fucking has multiple rings and who can always penetrate the basket if you ask him, because he's got one of the most dominant body builds in the NBA. 3-8 from three, bro, from the 3-point line. He, oh my, okay, maybe that isn't that bad. That's like 40-ish percent, okay? So maybe it isn't that bad. And then 50% free throw. This motherfucker missed half his free throws. This is your king, as Skip Bayley's would say. This is your king? Fuck no. Yeah, this was clutch play. I saw this play on my Instagram already. Austin Reeves from the Lakers tips in his own miss in the clutch, bro. In the clutch. Dude, it's... First of all, I'm going to call a Staples Center till I die. It's hard to not be a fan of Staples Centers, bro. It's the lighting, bro. It's like the whole like all the fans are like dark. They have no lighting. Not even a little bit. Like not even like some kind of flashing like disco lights or anything or colored lights. They only have light on the lights on the stage, dude, and it's like bright. So I think that's why it's so sick. They do the same pretty much for Madison Square Garden as well. I think that's why the two stadiums are so legendary in basketball history. The Spurs Coyote, that's boring. Kevin Love throws the long outlet pass to Darius Garland, who drops it back to Isaac Okoro for the rim record. All right, let's see it. They took a dub against the Nets yesterday. That was actually kind of lit. Lauri Markkanen played well as well. My boy, Lauri Markkanen. Imagine he becomes the next Kevin Love in the NBA. Ah! What a dunk. What a dunk. I like to see that kind of plays, bro. Ja Morant weaves it through the defense and finishes with the 360 layup. Damn, that was smooth. It's MLK Day, man. Hell yeah. Shout out MLK, man. That guy was inspirational. I'm not being sarcastic. Please. Please. Understand that I'm not being sarcastic. Oh, I don't want to watch this highlight, but okay, fine. Westbrook gets the add one on the international foul to put the Lakers up 8 with 40.3 left in the fourth. It was against Utah Jazz. It was kind of a tippable win. Yeah, we lit. Damn, the Lakers were lit last night. I got to tip it, man. Against the Utah Jazz, man. Ah. Stanley Johnson puts Gobert in the weight room and flex on. Stanley Johnson is a Lakers player, by the way. Another Lakers freaking highlight, man. Of course. Oh, he's got some speed. Oh, attacks. And one. Muscles him out a little bit, man. A little bit. Okay. That's all it is for today with the NBA. I swear it's going to end up just being friggin' LeBron James or KD highlights or Steph Curry highlights for the rest of the time. So let's go to the third top growing sports Reddit right now. Let me get a little sip of coffee in my head. Mouth is getting a little dry here, buddy, old pal. Ah. Oh, man. Cameraman at the Monaco GP. Okay, well, it's just a cool shot. It's just a cool shot of a cameraman in slow-mo. I can't show you. I really don't know how to describe it. It's pretty cool, but I can't show anyone anything. The official Senna Instagram page asked some NFT F1 page to take down their Senna NFT. Yeah, no, what the hell? Some random freaking kid was like, yeah, I'm gonna make a Senna NFT. Yep, that ain't right, man. If F1 wants to make NFTs, then yeah, maybe. I don't know. Everyone wants to do NFTs, bro. It's like free money in people's eyes. Some people's eyes. I'm not going to get into NFTs. I ain't gonna lie, bro. Oh my goodness gracious. Alain Prost frustrated how his announcement to leave Alpine was announced via Instagram. Oh my God. I'm very disappointed how this new has been announced today. It was agreed that we would announce together with Alpine F1 team. No respect. Sorry. I have refused the offer made to me in Abu Dhabi for the 2022 season because of a personal relationship. And I was right. To the Enstone and Viri team, I will miss you. Oh my God, dude. Oh my God. Alain Prost literally posted it on his Instagram. What a savage, bro. Safety. I mean, no. Wait, what? Sorry for the little burp. Dude, fuck that, dude. Fuck that. I can't, like... The car... Oh. New McLaren merch? That ain't it. That ain't it. Okay, well, this F1 Reddit is kind of whack right now, so I'm going to fuck off. Not going to even bullshit. Let's do... Okay, no. No. We're not going to look at crickets. Let's look at interest. Damn, that's interesting. This one's got 28K upvotes. Researchers in Siberia found a perfectly preserved 42,000-year-old baby horse buried under the permafrost. It was in such good condition that its blood was still in liquid state, allowing scientists to extract it. Oh my God. We're about to start making fucking dinosaurs. We're about to start reproducing dinosaurs, man. Oh my God. Jurassic Park is about to be a real thing. 42,000 years. Yo, dude, imagine. Okay, bro, just imagine anything alive from 42,000 years ago. Preserved. Like all the cells and shit. Oh my goodness gracious, that's crazy. Dude, there has to be more, bro. Because permafrost, think about it. Permafrost, there's examples of it in the modern era, bro. Like people who climb Mount Hill and die up on the Mount Everest. And they die up on the mountain and they freeze, bro. They're just permafrost. That's what it's called, permafrost. They're just perfectly preserved because they're just perfectly, like, they're just like completely frozen. So think about it. I don't know where the fuck they dug this out. Can I read about this somewhere? Fuck. It doesn't say where. I can't really see in the comments where they said they found it. Dude, people are saying in the comments they're Jurassic Park. Dude, 42,000 years ago. Oh my God, that shit is crazy, man. That's, dude, imagine like we freaking, imagine there was a human permafrosted for 42,000 years ago somewhere in the freaking icebergs of like Antarctica, dude. There has to be more, dude. This is probably like the first one, bro. Oh my God. I, for one, looking forward to Jurassic My Little Pony. My money is on the Velocipony. Dude, oh my God, man. I told you, Jurassic Park is about to be a real thing. 4,000, almost 5,000 upvotes. There's a cave painting of a human figure doggy styling another human figure. Nice. Nice. People been fucking, bruh. People been coming. Okay, I'm kidding. Oh my god. Game warden shows us the best use of a gun. So two deers were interlocked together and they were like, you know, because of their what are their horns? And they were interlocked because what? They probably started beefing or some shit. But they got tangled together, right? And they're obviously going to die if they keep on being tangled together. So, damn. Game warden, fucking, you blast them on the horns. And then gets them separated. That's fucking cool. That's fucking... And he ain't far away, man. This dude is like... No, he is far away. I'd say he is far away, considering... I don't know how accurate that gun is. Maybe he's using one of those bolt things, you know? Definitely not like a shotgun that has like spread pellets almost. So maybe he just had like one clean... It was like just perfectly interlocked in one horn, like one specific place. So he just got a good look at it. He's like in this video, I'm saying... He's maybe like 10 meters still away, so, you know. And these are like two deers that are just like kind of just, yeah. Yeah, this one went viral, man. 110K viewers. There's a dude up on a mountain playing banjo for a wild fox. And then there's... Of a fox just pulls up and he's just like enjoying the fuck out of this music, bro. This guy's fucking lit on the banjo as well, bro. He's turning it up, bro. And this fox just comes up and vibes, bro. It's a perfect kind of fox, dude. You like cartoons, you see how fox are, like this is how that fox is, man. Perfectly red. Oh my god, dude, the fox is like right next to him, just chilling around. The fox is looking at him, bro, vibing, goes past the cameraman or camerawoman, whatever. Oh, and he comes back for encore. Oh, my God. Keep on playing, bro. Sits down right in front of him, bro. Oh, my God. Looks at him. Ears are tweaking everywhere because the music is lit as fuck. Dude, music is something that's fucking crazy, bro. Dude, that's beautiful, man. I can't wait to go somewhere. I think this might be in, like, Canada or U.S. I'm just assuming. Man, I can't wait to go someplace like that. That's sick view. Yeah, people are saying in the comments, like, that's a fucking dope view. It is a dope view, man. Video of a snowfall. Captain Susie Garrett and her first officer daughter Donna are the first mother-daughter pair in history to pilot a commercial SkyWest Airlines flight together. Susie was one of the first dozen female pilots hired at SkyWest and has been flying there for over 30 years. Damn, that's lit. Damn, that's lit. Dude, but like, isn't there a rumor that like, at least like when a little bit like higher class, like airline kind of industry kind of society, it's kind of like crazy, bro. Don't they fuck like bunnies, like almost like Olympic athletes do, you know what I'm saying? When they get to the Olympic Village, you know what I'm saying, they got those steroids pumping and they just want to fucking, you know, give a girl a stabbing or something. I heard that shit was kind of like with the airlines, bro. Like, the captains are fucking horn dogs, you know? They just fucking slink dick left and right, you know? And then the flight attendants and also the female captains, they're fucking doing the same thing, you know? Slinging fucking pussy, you know? I don't know. That's kind of crazy, bro. How would that work, man? Like, the daughter wants to, you know... get downright disgusting one night. Maybe like they flew to like Barbados or some shit real quick, and then the mom's trying to also get a little frisky. You know what I'm saying? What would happen then, man? What's going down? Hopefully they have separate hotel rooms, you know what I'm saying? MLK, man. Shout out MLK, still. That guy was lit. This is... Oh, wait. Like, give me some upvotes, man. I don't... TikToks are in... Damn, that's interesting. Bruh. Wait, let me go all the way to the top. I'm gonna check like maybe top this month or something. It's gonna be the freaking Fox one. Oh, it ain't even. Oh my god. Astronaut Mark Kelly once smuggled a full gorilla suit on board the International Space Station. He didn't tell anyone about it. One day without anyone knowing, he put it on. And it's 181K upvotes. And it's literally him, the recording, it's only 15 second snippet, at least the one on Reddit. He just comes out of this freaking cardboard box, pretty much, in the gorilla suit. I think this is like pre-planned and stuff, and the cardboard box is just kind of floating around, and he goes from like section to section. There's a video of him chasing one of his colleagues down on the friggin' International Space Station, man. That's kind of lit. Italian singer Adriano Celentano released a song in the 70s with nonsense lyrics meant to sound like American English, apparently to prove Italians would like any English song. It was a huge hit. That is lit. I wish you guys can hear what I'm hearing right now. This guy's basically... Dude, he scammed the language, bro. That's how lit he is. He scammed the language and made money off of it. Wait, let me try to listen to what it sounds like. He's saying like... He's kind of like... Yeah, no, maybe not like that. Maybe he's like, you, I don't know. Something like, it doesn't, no, I'm making it sound more Italian than it actually is. Wait, I'm gonna put it on for you guys for a little bit. Oh my god, they're jiving, bro. You hear that? So it's gibberish. It's gibberish, but it definitely does sound like English, man. It definitely does sound like English a little bit. So, damn. Made some buckaroos off of that in the 70s, huh? Damn, that's crazy. The 1985 movie Clue was released theatrically with three completely different endings. Each screening would randomly show one. The home video release contained all three endings. Wow. What a promo, man. Everybody must have wanted to play buy the CD then. Oh my god. Wow. What a marketing scheme. Either they bought the CD to see how the other endings went, or they are so addicted, they love the movie so much, and they heard about, obviously, the word goes around, they heard about so much, they can spend a few more buckaroos and watch the whole, bro, imagine, no, but that's the thing, they randomly put one, so imagine you spend a few buckaroos in hopes of seeing the other ending, you end up seeing the same ending. Oh my god. I would lose fucking composure, man. That would be horrible. That would be absolutely horrible. Oh man. Oh man. Hopefully people figured it out at the end of the day though. Don Rickles passed away before he was able to record any dialogue for Toy Story 4. Rather than replacing him, Disney reviewed 25 years of material from first three films, video games, and other media. They were able to assemble enough dialogue to cover the entire film. Wow. I still haven't seen Toy Story 4. I ain't gonna lie, bro. I hope people don't get mad at me for that. But I don't know. Kids' movies are just like, God, man. I don't know. I don't have the same joy in watching kids' movies anymore. You know what I'm saying? Or like animated movies. I know, dude. Like, I haven't even seen Cars 3 either. I haven't even seen Kung Fu Panda 3, man. Oh, my God. You know why, bro? I watched fucking, what's that? Finding Doris, bro. The sequel to Finding Nemo. They're finding Doris, bro, and she's got like short-term memory loss or long-term memory loss or something. Man, that movie was a mess in my opinion. It got a little too much, you know what I'm saying? Or at least when I watched it. I went to watch it in the theaters too. Maybe it ruined it because I was at the theaters. Maybe it's like more at home, but fuck, man. Dude, what's the last good kid movie I've watched, dude? I can't even. Or like anime. I'm not gonna say kid movie because they can be family movies as well. Oh man, I don't even know, man. I've just been watching like good serious movies. Not serious, but like, you know. Whatever. Several decades after release of Jaws in 1975, Lee Fierro, who played Mrs. Kintner, walked into a seafood restaurant and noticed that the menu had an Alex Kintner sandwich. She commented that she had played his mother so many years ago. The owner of the restaurant ran out to meet her, and he was none other than Jeffrey Voorhees, who had played her son. They had not seen each other since the original movie shoot. Wow, that's crazy. Small world. Bees are crazy, man. Don't even get me started with bees, man. There's a group of elephants crossing the road while there's probably a car waiting or something. And then, an elder elephant waits at the end and thanks the car driver for letting them go. No way. Yeah, dude. With his little trunk, he just waves. Hey. Thanks, man. Wait, that's not an elephant sound. It's more like, yo, thanks, bye, my brother. Is that too racist? Or is it like, hey, man? Or be like, oh, my God. It'd be like, hey, man, thanks a lot. I appreciate it, man. Maybe like that. 50% of Canadians live south of the red line. What? And the red line is like, oh my god, it's just like above Montreal or something. Oh my god. Friggin' Canadians, bruh. Wow, that's some crazy shit. Bedtime time lapse with pets. Okay, I don't really give a fuck. Do-do-do-do-do, that's an audio daily double. All right, so this is the richness level I want to get at in my life, right? If I can open at least a five, at some point in my life, now, I'm not saying like it has to be a regular thing, but like once in my life, I order myself a five-figure bottle of red wine, vintage red wine. And I open it how you're supposed to open old wine bottles and old expensive vintage wine bottles like that, dude. You got to use this, you got to use like a tong basically that you heat till it's like red hot. And then you just like freaking squeeze. Like, imagine if this was a wine bottle and this is the top, like skinny part, the neck of the bottle. You get a tong and you heat it red hot and you just like start squeezing it like this or something. And then it just goes through the glass nice and smooth. Right? It like smoothly opens it, right? Because of the tongs, they're like rounded out. Man, that's how. And then let me show you. Yeah, there's a video of it. So they slowly press it. They press it. They keep on putting the pressure, and it's hot. Oh yeah! And before you remove it, you swipe it with a little bit of water and a brush, bro. And then boom, the neck pops off beautifully, and you're ready to enjoy some five motherfucking figure bottle of red, bro, of great juice, brother. Yeah, this is one of the craziest parts of, there's this guy called Chalino Sanchez, that was had a big cult following, at least, Mexican artist who performed like some crazy good songs. And, but he got into a little bit of a mess, man, and with like the cartel and stuff, and it got too messy at one point and there was no way out. So he gets handed a note while he's performing on stage. You know, he's got his cowboy hat on and everything like that. He's kind of in good spirits, right? Or he's got to still show like he's in good spirits. But the note that he gets handed is a fucking death note, telling him that after this performance, you're dead. You're fucking dead. You're gonna go fucking swim with the fishes. Look at him. He's soulless. Soulless, man. He reads it. Band's still playing. And then his fucking heart drops down to his fucking asshole. And then he has 20 seconds to deal with it, and then he's back to singing. Wow, what a crazy life, man. What a crazy life, man. Oh, what a shame, too. I've heard about him before, and I've listened to some of his songs. There's some fucking jivey songs, man. What a shame. Jar and Tortoise moving in full speed, and they're fucking slow. Give me a fucking surprise. There's a trippy video of a match ignition at 4,000 frames per second. Okay, cool. After the White House claimed for more than a year that Bob Woodward and Carl Bernstein were making up stories and creating fictional sources, here they are watching President Richard Nixon resign on television. Lol. Okay, well, I don't really know the backstory of that, but seems interesting. Oh my God. Not safe for work. In Victorian times, gentlemen going to war or on their travels would leave behind mementos for their ladies in the form of carved ivory dildos of their own appendage, sometimes engraved as forget me not. They now command prices in the thousands. What? Oh my God, man. That is an antique dildo, man. That's fucking lit. So fuck Fleshlight, man. This the OG Fleshlight, motherfuckers. Yeah, don't forget about me, baby fucking girl. I'm gonna come back. When I come back from the war, I'm gonna be fucking all jacked up on testosterone and fucking ready to sling dick and give you a fucking proper stabbing in a monkey. Oh my God, that's crazy, bro. Now command prices in the thousands, bro. I'd pay thousands to get fucked or kind of get fucked by someone in the Victorian times. Like, if you really think about it, like, if you really think about it, if a lady gets that Victorian times fucking dildo, she's probably gonna fucking use it. I mean, like, yo, like, listen, let's be real, bruh. She's probably gonna use that shit. It ain't for fucking, you know, like, look at this. It ain't for the collection, you know what I'm saying? It's for the bedroom collection, you know what I'm saying? So if she fucking uses that, that's like you're getting fucked by a Victorian gentleman that's about to go to war. And you're just fucking, dude, this thing looks fucking huge. I don't know how big that box is relative to anything, but it looks like a solid, like 6 to 8, you know, fucking inches, you know? Oh, Jesus, that's crazy, man. That's crazy. Yeah, I would be down, bro. I'd pay some good money for an experience like that, you know what I'm saying? I don't want to watch TikToks in my freaking Reddit, man. This ain't it. Oh my God, wait, what? So there's a spider chilling around a freaking viper, right? There's a spider chilling around on top of like a spider tail. Oh my God, wait. Oh, is that a fucking tail? No fucking way. Don't tell me that's a tail, bro. Wait, that's a tail? That is cracked, man. His tail literally looks like a spider, man. Wow. So then the bird comes and flies in and looks at, only sees the spider because the viper is decorated in the stones, you know? So he only sees the tail that is literally, it's got like legs and shit almost. It literally looks like a spider. So the bird comes down and the viper just fucking attacks. Wow, that is fucking crazy. That is crazy, man. Huh. There's no shot. There's no shot. That's fake. They said that in 1933, when they had the cars, the fifth wheel they'd have in the back, you know, so there's the four wheels, obviously. And then the fifth wheel, which would be the extra wheel in the back of the car, you know, remember they used to put it in the back of the car. They said in 1933, there was a freaking car that like the fifth wheel was not like an extra wheel to like replace another wheel. It was just, it would go down using a suspension. I guess they had hydraulics in 1933. Wait, I'm gonna search that up real quick. Did they have I don't know how to spell hydraulic. Technology when invented when. Let's just say that. I worded it badly, but Google's smart enough. In 1738, a Swiss mathematician called Daniel Bernoulli put this theory into practice. He used pressurized water in mills and pumps. Oh, okay. 1975, an Englishman called Joseph Bramah patented the first hydraulic press. So what? The technology was around? Maybe they didn't use a hydraulic press. I'm getting out of topic. But maybe they just used some kind of suspension or something. Yeah, dude, it lifted the car up so it'd go down. You know, obviously it's like elevated, right? But then it goes down and it basically, because it's like the wheels are like here, but then this one's like facing the other way. It just goes down and then the car can basically spin around it. in a perfect circle, and they would use it to help parallel parking, man. That's crazy. Didn't know they had that. Damn, 1995, Bill Gates is in a David Letterman show, and people are giving him shit for saying that internet's the next big thing. That's crazy. Wow, that's crazy. What year is this? That's Formula One for sure. Oh, no, that was IndyCar. Okay, so methanol fire is invisible. So basically there's a video of cockpit in IndyCar and something goes wrong, I guess, with methanol, or somehow methanol is released, or something catches on fire, and it's just invisible. You just kind of see people freaking out, running away, people using fire extinguishers, but you can't see it. It's like just invisible, so it just kind of looks like everyone's freaking out over nothing. An Abdopus octopus is the only known octopus to leave the water and walk on land. Oh my god, these guys are cracked, dude. Octopus are the closest things to aliens in real life. I'm convinced. I'm convinced, man. Giant bear casually walks past tourists in Alaska's Katmai National Park. He just had to make sure his face was still on the sign. Holy fuck, that thing is giant. If it attacked me or anyone in the video, they'd be dead in fucking blink of an eye. Snap of a fucking finger. Twitch of an eye, motherfucker. Motherfucker. Wow. He just looks at himself or a bear on the friggin' on the national park, some kind of stand or sign or something. Oh my god, that thing's fucking fat and huge, bro. Bears scare me, man. I ain't gonna lie, if I saw a bear, I'd probably piss myself, bruh. Bears are one of them motherfuckers, man. Bears are one of them motherfuckers. Hugh Grant pretended to be his own talent agent and saved a lot of money. For 4 years, Hugh Grant pretended to be his own talent agent. He communicated with people using a fake email account under the name James Ho Ely, and even disguised his voice on the phone with a Scottish accent. I saved myself an absolute fortune, he said. Yeah. Those talent agents take a big percentage, bruh. Water speed is set to 24.3, and everyone gets a chance for an attempt. Damn, these guys are pro swimmers. They can't even keep up, man. Swimming like butterfly and backfly. Backstyle? Dude, I don't even know these terms anymore, bro. Please tell me they swim freestyle. Yeah. Go. 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 What? You could have kept going, dude. Okay, they only did it for the video, man. They could have kept going, man. This is Warwick Dunn. His mom was a Baton Rouge police officer who was shot and killed while he was a senior in high school. He raised his 5 siblings while in college, graduated, and went to the NFL. He built and paid for over 145 homes for single mothers, sacrificing millions of dollars so they can have better lives. Warwick Dunn, a true hero. Boom. I love that out of sports, man. I absolutely love that out of sports. Yeah. What? Nikola Tesla's foot x-ray taken by himself on a machine he designed 1896? Dude, Isn't there a whole conspiracy theory about Nikola Tesla, how we don't know fucking anything about him, even though he revolutionized modern technology and how we live today? Like, dude, he was in a fucking magic movie that Christopher Nolan made, for God's sake. That's crazy, dog. That's actually crazy, dog. World's biggest swing. Holy shit, that is so fucking lit. That's not even funny. I want to hit that shit so bad. It's over a cliff of a mountain or some kind of waterfall too. Damn. Applying sunscreen under visible light versus UV light. Okay. I don't really, no. I don't want to see TikToks. Man, we get it, man. A teenager who was dying of an incurable illness had the single wish of meeting Luke Skywalker. The disease had eroded his memory and devolved his cognition functions to the point where he could not realize that Luke was fictional. Oh, shit, that's crazy. Mark Hamill agreed to meet him in character, answered questions about Princess Leia and spaceships as Luke Skywalker. That's fucking cool. All right, we're going to go to interesting as fuck now. So we were in the subreddit called That's Damn, That's Interesting. Now we're at interesting as fuck. First post is about MLK, of course. Of course, it's about how he was freaking perceived back in the day, man. It's cool how we've at least developed, really well as a society. So that guy is beloved by all. Riding abandoned railroad tracks in Southern California, California with my rail cart. That's fucking lit, man. They're just going. They're just cruising, bro. That's lit. Damn, there's a. I was just checking if that video was. In case you have not seen what a clump of DNA looks like. Yeah, that's true. It just looks like, You know what that looks like, man? You know what I'm looking at, man? It looks like there's a test tube full of water. And it kind of just looks like. It kind of looks like what would come out of the tip of my. Penis after the seventh jerk of a day, where it just kind of hurts, but you kind of just have to do it, and you just get a few little disgusting drops, and that's what it looks like. It just looks like those drops went inside a test tube full of water. Oh man, that's what DNA looks like, ladies and gentlemen. If you didn't know, you can actually see DNA. Damn, that's crazy. What you are seeing laid out on the table is the monthly ration per Polish citizen in the mid-80s. 12 packs of cigarettes, 300 grams of washing powder, 2 bars of soap, 0.5 liter of vodka, 500 grams of butter, 2.5 kilograms of meat, cooking oil, 1 pack. Sweets, 250 grams. Rice, 1.3 kilograms. Sugar. Monthly ration? That's fucked. For each. Okay, well, maybe that's not... Okay, obviously it's already fucked that people had to have, like, monthly rations. And then there's still sugar, 2 kg, and flour, 1.3 kg. So, it's fucked, obviously, that there was... society had to be at a point where the citizens have a monthly ration, but hopefully, I'm just assuming, hopefully the better outcome was that was per Polish citizen, like, so it doesn't matter how many people you have in a family. So if you had a relatively big family, you got a okay amount of food. And think about the amount of booze you get back. The amount of booze and cigarettes you get. If one person gets half a liter of vodka and fucking 12-pack of cigarettes for a month. Okay, 12-pack isn't that much for a month of cigarettes, all right? That's just like just doable. But then you have like kids. Imagine if kids still got like 12 packs and a half a liter of vodka. Oh my God. Parents gonna be fucking drinking and smoking all the time, man. 24/7. That's very interesting though. Man, I'm always going down on my chair, man. Freaking sliding down, man, with my ass. Yeah, last night was full moon, man. It was beautiful. I was looking at that stuff, man. Tiger, known as Caller Wally, who contributed 29 cubs to the Pench Tiger Reserve over 16 years, cremated with full honors. Damn. Rest in peace. Dude, that's the kind of beautiful animals you need to give a proper send-off to, man. Those things are, they're the ones that rule this world at the end of the day, man. Because you can't, the thing is, you can't fuck with a motherfucker like a tiger. In society, you can fuck with another person, and they're not gonna come out and fucking devour you with their claws and their fucking teeth. But you fuck with a tiger, all it's gonna fucking know is I'm gonna fucking bite your head off, you fucking cocksucking moron. Fuck with me again. Those guys rule the world, man. Those guys rule the world, man. So much big ups to the tigers, man. No, but seriously, shout out to those beautiful creatures, man. Those beautiful creatures. Tattoo fan has spent over 100,000 inking his entire body. Damn, that's lit. That's not even that bad if you really think about it. People spend easily 100,000 on maybe a bit of a nicer car. So, damn, bro. Someone found 12,800 coconuts full of methamphetamines. Damn, the cartel took an L, man. Farm animals work together to save a chicken from a hawk attack. No way. Oh my God, look at a chicken's pull up, bro. Oh, and a goat pulls up on the boy too. Holy shit. Oh, and another goat. And there's another chicken running wild, bro. Oh my God. Yeah. We the community, bruh. A city in Germany has made these thermally insulated pods for homeless people to sleep. These units are known as Ulmanest. Interesting. I like Germany, bro. Germany's got... Germany progresses really fast, man. They do their thing, man. These sand sculptures formed by strong winds eroding frozen sand. What? Oh my God. These are like sand. They're literally sand sculptures formed naturally. That's crazy, man. The rocket carrying James Webb's Space Telescope is seen from my backyard in Nepal. That's crazy. Colors of a sky. That's crazy. Thermal imaging camera shows how the human body loses heat when exposed to the blistering cold. Okay, so obviously hands and face is already getting a little cold. Neck is warm. Now he gets into his t-shirt. His arms are warm. His hands are cold at this point. His neck is getting colder and colder. He's completely naked on his upper body. Yeah, his scalp is getting cold as well. That's crazy. Thermal cameras are fucking crazy, man. And then, yeah, his, oh man, that's crazy. He touches his chest with his hand and then it leaves like a mark of warmth in his. That's crazy, man. That's actually crazy. These were some of the members of the Ku Klux Kitties. It was a youth group run by the KKK. That's fucking crazy, man. That's actually crazy. Got kids into that stuff, man. Kids are wearing hoods and shit. That's fucked. The Northern Lights in real time. That's fucked. That's a little bit crazy, man. I don't know about that video. That video must be in someplace special because I saw Northern Lights in my city here in Pori, Finland. And this is maybe like close to like center Finland or like the middle of Finland, right? I'm on the west coast. But I saw them, man. I saw them in a city with like, there was like traffic light, obviously quite a lot of light pollution, but I still saw it. So I didn't see it moving that much, so. Oh my god, this is about to be disgusting. So there's a mantis dipped into some liquid, and it's like the title of it is forcing out a parasite. Oh my god, that parasite is crawling the fuck out of that mantis, man. Oh my god, that is huge parasite. It was like fucking four times the length of the mantis and just crawls out of the asshole of the mantis, man. Fuck. Yeah, that's crazy. It's in Manhattan, New York, man. This 550-foot building with no windows. It's creepy. I don't know who came up with that, but it's fucking creepy. Victor Noir's grave in Paris-Lachaise Cemetery. Backstory in comments. Oh, shit. I don't know if I want to get into this. How deep are we? Okay, this might be the last thing we're going to read. A provocative statue against expectations. It wasn't his death or the political consequences of the shooting that made Victor Noir famous. It was his grave. 20 years after Noir's death in 1891, following the establishment of the Third French Republic, the body of Victor Noir was moved from his hometown to Paris-Lachaise Cemetery in Paris to honor his name and memory. A renowned French sculptor, Jules Dalou, was given the job of creating the sculpture in bronze for Noir's name. Dalou chose to depict Victor Noir at the moment of his death, lying flat on the ground. After he was shot, for reasons unknown, he decided to give the sculpture a noticeable bulge under the belt, which triggered the formation of a really bizarre myth that over time made Victor Noir's tomb a symbol of fertility and sexual happiness. Becoming a fertility symbol, it is believed that if a woman kisses the statue of Victor Noir on the lips, rubs the bulge in his trousers and drops a flower in his hat, it will bring her enhanced fertility and a blissful sex life. Oh my god. More specifically, if you want to find a beautiful lover, you should kiss Noir's lips. If you want to get pregnant, you should touch his right foot. If you want to have twins, you should touch his left foot. According to the myth, a baby will follow soon after, and single ladies will find a husband within the year. The statue itself, a living proof of the people take this myth very seriously. Victor Noir's lip, groin, and shoes are very shiny, while the rest of his body, the usual greenish tone of oxidized bronze. That is why in 2004, a fence was placed around the statue of Noir with a warning sign, any damage caused by graffiti or indecent rubbing will be prosecuted. Indecent rubbing. But this agitated so many women that the fence was soon torn down. Today, a woman who had fallen pregnant after visiting Victor Noir's grave returned to the cemetery in gratitude and put photos of their children and other objects in a hat near the statue. That is so the picture that is, oh my god, my apple flew. The picture that is in question is this lady that is, there's flowers all over Victor Noir's grave, and this lady is in her panties, lingerie or whatever, just grinding on fucking Victor Noir, man. Victor Noir in bronze, man. This is what I imagine Princess Leia would have done to Han Solo if Han Solo was stuck in that that freaking rock box for a little longer. Damn, that's crazy, bro. Maybe I should go there. But it's for women. Fuck. Victor Noir, get me a fucking lady, man. Oh my god. Maybe I'll meet a lady there. Little desperate lady there. Oh my god. People, dudes definitely go there to try to pick up desperate chicks there. For sure, man. Oh my god. Maybe I need to go there. Fuck. During the Prohibition era, the wine industry released grape bricks, which was concentrated grape juice with a warning that literally had the directions to make wine. It read, after dissolving a brick in a gallon of water, do not place in a cupboard for 20 days because it will turn to wine. Oh my god. And that was, dude, that's like, that's crazy, man. That's, dude, there's always been loopholes, man. There's always been loopholes. This guy in Antarctica captured the only solar eclipse in 2021. That's crazy. A black heron using its wings like an umbrella, creating shade to attract fish. A behavior known as canopy feeding. Wow, this guy's like making a little fucking cuckoo with his wings, bro. It's like, that's crazy. Abandoned Countach in Dubai, sad. That's a sexy car, bro. They're just abandoning sexy cars around the world. It's crazy. Okay, I'm not going to watch that. I'm not going to get into that. That was an open heart surgery. No, thanks. I'm good, man. I'm good. Let's see how cinnamon is harvested, bro. It's off a tree. This guy's basically just skinning out a tree right now. And then what? He just slices the bark open real nice. Slices it open, the skin still, and then what you get, like, it's the bark, man. Oh, or it's like the inside skin or whatever. Right. You can grind it up and shit. Wow, that's crazy. That's amazing. Chinese man seizes. Oh, I saw this. He was like folded for his life, and then they unfolded him. Great. And I thought this was a CGI effect. No, it's a Matrix fucking shoot. It's like behind the scenes of Matrix, bro. That's crazy. They just got like thousands of lookalikes instead of like CGI, man. This woman never existed. AI generated image. Wow, that's a woman that never existed. That's crazy. But if you really think about it, no woman ever exists until they get born. So, you know what I'm saying? So I guess it's relatively, I don't think that's like crazy amazing. Because like, I don't know if this is too deep, but like for me, like every time I see like a new face, say like I'm walking in the public, right? In the streets, I go past like a person. And I look at him and I see that person for the first time. They always like, you know, they look like a human being. That's it. So, but it's like I never knew a face could or existed that looked like that until I saw it. So, you know what I'm saying? So I guess it's not, I don't find it super impressive that AI has generated like a human face, even though that's completely random. There's box jellyfish that literally looks like it's out of this fucking planet, and they are same like octopus, dude. They're fucking aliens. If people think aliens are up on the sky, bro, capping. Aliens are fucking down under the sea, bro. They're down there creeping, man. Down there freaking creeping, man. And we're going to end this with we're going to end this with one more. We're going to end this podcast with one funny thing. Funny old thing. I can't come up with anything, actually. I'm trying to look at funny stuff on Reddit, but there's no funny stuff. They put GIFs everywhere, man. Memes used to be more than just things you look at, man. They used to be also things you can read, man. Bone-hurting juice? What? What? I don't get any of these memes, bro. I'm looking at them. What? I don't get this. Dude, no. You're chalking it right now. You're making me unhappy. You're making me have unsmooth fucking, you know, like, ending to this fucking podcast, man. I gotta get my shizzle together, bruh. Let's go news. Offbeat? What is offbeat? Funny, weird, sad news. Tell me some. Give me some funny news, bro. What? Somebody. Astronauts found to destroy. No. What? Give me something funny, man. Oh my god. As things fall apart, the super rich spend $2 million on whiskey. We need a wealth tax. No, we do not. Whiskey is the best fucking brown juice there's ever been for the fucking human mankind. Give me a fucking Jameson, a triple Jameson on the Fox. Fox? Rocks? Papa Doc? Drew Locks? Yo, listen. Don't fucking cap on whiskey, alright? It's the best fucking brown juice. It's the best shit in the world. All right, there ain't a better booze than whiskey. Why do you think back in Prohibition era, where shit was illegal, you had these fucking rich, every single rich person, you go to a meeting, hey, you want a little scotch, you want a little bit of Irish, you want a little bit of just a whiskey, you know, and you got to toast a whiskey after you make a business deal, bro. Whiskey's the shit. Whiskey's the fucking shit, man. Whiskey's the shit. So I don't give a fuck. Rich people got money. Spend it on the best fucking thing you can drink on earth, bro. Let's go. I'll see you guys later, man. It's been a nice-ass podcast. I've been really, been learning a lot about the world, man. Crazy. And also, had a good conversation overall, man. So, I'll see you guys later. I'll see you guys later. Hope you guys had a good one. Oh, man. Hope you guys had a good Tuesday. Enjoy. I'll see ya in the next one. Peace out, homie. Peace out.